Do I need antivirus for Windows 11 now that this is about to become the only Windows OS we're allowed to have? The quest for the best antivirus protection lives in my head rent-free. Since macOS is also increasingly targeted by hackers and malware, yeah, it's time to solve those issues with the best antivirus for PC review. Let's go. Now, to avoid wasting your time, the providers that I'm going to cover today are TotalAV, Norton, and Bitdefender. So the reason that I consider them the best example of antivirus protection software lies in their core features. This is not limited to malware scans from quick surface level ones to full deep digging. While scans are vital, real-time protection is where the core function of an antivirus lies, since this feature is the guarantee that no malware makes its way onto my PC, either from a download, a malicious advert, or a sneaky phishing message. A similar purpose lies in a firewall, which actively blocks any malicious websites, trackers, and other internet-based threats. Now, only TotalAV lacks a firewall, though this provider prefers to rely on an OS firewall paired with their traffic monitoring web shield feature. This combination is no less powerful than dedicated firewalls from Bitdefender or Norton. All those features function solely because each provider regularly updates its malware databases and apps, ensuring that no malware is left unaccounted for. But what makes Bitdefender, TotalAV, and Norton such good antivirus protection apps is their availability on all platforms. Whether I use them on Windows or macOS, the features and functionality are the same. Plus, I can even protect my mobile devices if I want. That's a great level of versatility. For many of you, this is the full extent of antivirus protection you're ever gonna need. So feel free to grab an antivirus of your liking through the link in the description. This will also give you a YouTube exclusive discount. Now, while all those core features promise top-level protection, are they as effective as I need them to be? The AV Test Independent Research Institute exists to answer this question by testing antivirus software in three categories: protection, performance, and usability. The first is self-explanatory. The second evaluates how much the antivirus affects computer resources. And the third discusses possible internet limitations or false alarms. Now, on Windows, TotalAV, Norton, and Bitdefender all score maximum points in the latest testing. 6 out of 6, a perfect score. The results are almost the same on macOS. The only difference is with TotalAV, which is 5.5 for protection. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, losing half a point for 0.5% of malware missed out of 428 samples, I think that's a bit harsh and unfair. What do you think? Now, this is exactly why I routinely test software on my own. I start by downloading 100 different malware samples and then seeing how many an antivirus can catch. Now, these tests are done without real-time protection, just malware scanning. Since I couldn't download any malware files with RTP on, they were just getting eliminated on site. Now, in any case, here are the full scan results for the best antivirus for Mac. Okay, as you can see, almost 100% malware was detected from each provider, and the scan itself barely took any time, less than 20 minutes for all of them. Considering that full scans usually have to dig deep into the system, this is an impressive result, especially since the CPU load was practically non-existent for all providers, save for TotalAV. Now, on Windows 11, my tests were not that awe-inspiring. Okay, while real-time protection still didn't let me download any malware, these antiviruses on PC caught fewer files than on macOS. The scans took over an hour for TotalAV and Bitdefender, even though Norton maintained a sub-20-minute pace. Norton also used the least of my CPU during the scans, while the other two proved pretty greedy for resources. Now, I partly blame Windows 11 for those results. So my previous tests on Windows 10 showed much better numbers across the board. Now, why does Microsoft make us switch to this undercooked OS? Well, either way, I'm at least content that with a combination of real-time protection and malware scan, I can protect my PC with Bitdefender, Norton, or TotalAV alike. But the question remains, is that antivirus protection worth the price? Antiviruses were quite infamous for their steep pricing curves in the past, and I noticed that many modern users have kept that expectation from the 2010s. However, in this day and age, antivirus protection is more affordable than ever. Only providers like ESET are still stuck in the past. As you can see from this pricing breakdown, you don't have to break your piggy bank to get a good antivirus. TotalAV is one of the most affordable providers on the market, while Bitdefender and Norton are only marginally more expensive with their advanced plans. For the best antivirus software, I give you the best deals as well. Remember, you can always check the links in the description for the exclusive antivirus deals or scan this QR code for a TotalAV discount if that sounds easier. Since I've just shown you how affordable those advanced plans can get, it's time for me to showcase what exciting extra features you can get with this discount link. So, to give you a basic understanding, all three have a VPN, an ad blocker, password manager built into the app. At this point, all antiviruses have this, but that's not the end. Best antivirus options always have something extra, like TotalAV's system tune-up tool. This feature actively removes trash files, error logs, and other temporary files to optimize my system's performance. This feature comes in handy whenever I'm rendering a video. My PC would be lagging way more without it working in the background. I've also previously mentioned Web Shield. That's an online protection feature TotalAV often uses alongside the system's firewall to prevent online threats from affecting my device. Besides simply detecting malicious websites, Web Shield can blacklist them, detect malicious activity on seemingly safe pages, and so on. While TotalAV does a good job with extra features, there are not many of them. In comparison, Norton stands out with its sizable arsenal. Its cloud backup is impressive simply because I can have up to 250 gigabytes of encrypted, secure cloud storage for any of my files. I mean, with how big the footage gets for my channel, this is a godsend. LifeLock identity theft protection is also a feature that I've started to appreciate way more recently, as current statistics show identity fraud to be on the rise again. At this point, LifeLock might be the only reason I remained unaffected. Norton also started dabbling more into AI, releasing the Genie Scam Protection Pro, an AI-powered feature trained to detect scams, phishing emails, and other social engineering attacks. Usually, I take all AI tools with a grain of salt, but current AI models are perfect for detecting patterns, and this is exactly why Genie works so well. So most social engineering attacks follow clear patterns that the AI cracks in an instant. So unlike TotalAV or Norton, Bitdefender's best extras are essentially powerful upgrades for its core features. For instance, multi-layer ransomware protection is an advanced feature designed to block encryption attempts from ransomware, prevent data loss, and also back up all important files prior to attempted encryption. Functionally, I'll be fine even if some of the layers fall to the powerful attacks. Now, Bitdefender's zero-day cloud scanning is also a great feature against the most dangerous type of malware. Zero days are risky because they're not recorded in the databases yet, so many antivirus software programs can't catch them reliably. And yet Bitdefender employs advanced scanning to predict zero-day attacks and prevent them from taking action. So from this feature overview, you might have noticed that Bitdefender and Norton are a bit more complex, and this is true for their UI and UX in general. Advanced users will clearly appreciate various enhanced features, in-depth customization, and straightforward design approach, but what about beginners? Well, I do consider TotalAV a great antivirus for inexperienced users. Despite offering fewer features, TotalAV provides a user-friendly experience with distinctly customizable features. At the end of the day, if you need the best antivirus for PC or macOS, TotalAV is the best option for beginners with solid security and enough extra features. Now, Bitdefender and Norton are both more advanced antiviruses. The former is the best if you need really strong malware protection and guarantees against ransomware and zero-day attacks, while the latter provides the best cybersecurity suite with an array of various protection features. Now, whichever strikes your fancy, remember you can get a special discount for an antivirus of your choice in the description below. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye.